Oh my god, ada podcast.
Orang sibuk tanya kita kan, bila nak buat podcast, bila nak buat podcast. Ha, ambil kau. Dah kasi dah ni.
Apa khabar semua? Nama saya Hafiz Rahman.
Saya Zuhair Idris dan kami dari Lepak One Corner. Dan selamat datang ke Lepak One Corner The Podcast.
Mesti ramai yang tanya tau, kenapa tiba-tiba kita nak buat podcast? Dah lama kan orang suruh kita buat podcast tapi tak buat-buat. Sekarang ni, why? Why you want to do a podcast now, Zuhair Idris?
Sebab suka hati kita lah nak buat bila.
That's true.
Is that a reason kenapa kita buat benda ni? Actually tak.
No, okay. Because personally, aku tak nak buat in the beginning because I'm not I don't listen to podcast myself. So, pada aku macam a bit janggal untuk aku buat podcast. But I think
the market is there lah.
The market is there. So, kita seorang yang opportunist kan. Jadi, apa-apa yang ada, kita buat lah.
Yeah, I mean like, you know, kita tengok peredaran masa dan juga tengok market lah. Sebab ini kita punya, orang kata apa tu, currency kan. We are looking for all these opportunities yang ada lah kat market sekarang ni lah. No, okay, one of the reason why I also thought macam kita seharusnya buat podcast sebab I realise ramai kawan-kawan saya. Say kawan-kawan saya, kawan-kawan aku boleh tak?
Boleh,
aku,
boleh.
Kau boleh eh? Korang, boleh. Korang okay kan dengan perbahasan macam ni? Okay. Kawan-kawan aku jenis yang apa tu? Diorang, some of them they drive, you see. So the only way of entertainment bila diorang drive is podcast. Takkan diorang tengok YouTube and drive kan? Tu bahaya.
Itulah.
So I was thinking, okay lah, so podcast ni untuk another golongan yang lebih suka dari segi deria pendengaran daripada deria penglihatan eh.
And I think also because now we are living in a time of pandemic, jadi agak sukar untuk kita nak buat video kan. We need to do a lot of things, need to take note of a lot of clearances that we need. Jadi saya rasa podcast is a way for us to keep on entertaining you guys lah.
Sorry
jadi,
lah, kita bukan essential. Sebab tu kita tak ada tak ada license kan nak buat benda ni semua.
Kita bukan. Kita sedar diri yeah.
Kita sedar diri.
Lagipun jangan takut. Okay, mungkin pada anda semua tertanya-tanya what is the podcast all about. Jangan takut, okay. Sebenarnya kita ni akan berbual tentang pelbagai isu. Okay, we'll be talking about a lot of issues but primarily pertaining to the Malay community lah.
Yes,
right?
The primary school. My primary school is at Fauli Primary School. So, yalah, no longer exist lah. The school close lah. They merge and then no longer exist.
So, no non-existent lah?
No, non-existent lah. Like the dinosaur lah.
Extinct lah. Extinction. Yeah.
What about you? Your primary school? How still around?
My primary school is Peking Primary School. It's one of the best schools in Yishun apparently. It's one of the first schools that has got...
Riak lah ni, riak lah.
Tak, riak. Cakap aja. Because, you know, like, attention is the currency of the world, right? So, I want to give all the attention that I can give, you know?
Yeah.
And get all the attention that I can get. But jangan khawatir. We will not be selling lah, kucing aku bergaduh pula. Susah lah kalau aku buat.
Susah kan buat kat rumah ni.
Podcast kat rumah. Kucing bergaduh. Hey.
Okay, so basically kalau kau nak tahu macam mana kita punya podcast punya kata konsep macam ni lah. Sahaja, selamba. And we purposely decided to do it at home. Sebab kita nak benda ni santai sahaja. Kita tak nak too formal. We don't want to do it at the studio or like, you know, very... that kind of place. So kita nak buat kat rumah sahaja. Jadi apa-apa yang berlaku korang boleh tahulah. Boleh dengar
kalau orang ketuk pintu ke kan. Kalau penunggu datang
correct.
Ke kau tahulah.
Cuma korang tak boleh nampak adik Hafiz jalan bugil ke apa. Tak nampak.
Tapi ada lah.
Tapi ada lah kat sini.
Kelibat susuk tubuh orang yang bugil jalan belengas ada. Cuma tak nampak. Kurang. Aku susah lah. You know, I've been so stressed this past few days because I'm living in a rented flat, right? So aku terpaksa nak kena buat macam all my Zoom engagements online. So sekali tu aku buat Zoom online dengan
to explain it kan?
To explain it. Aku tengah interview, ada orang bogey lah. Bukan bogey lah, macam belengas lah jalan kat belakang.
Sebab ada barang datang.
Okay.
Tapi luckily itu recording saja. Itu bukan live. Tapi dalam recording tu kita ada guest tau. Sebab kita nak interview guest. So the guest from Malaysia are there. Were there and they saw Hafiz punya
brother.
Adalah susuk-susuk yang menakutkan.
Kan? So I'm very thankful that we have this outlet for us to actually really talk about a lot of things lah. But don't worry, I think we will push the envelope and we will talk about taboo things and we will talk about controversial things.
Oh, ten envelope juga eh?
Ada. There's a lot of envelopes to be sent out.
I see.
So for example, if I push this envelope, you must receive it lah.
Ah, okay, but you must understand lah, the envelope that we are pushing is sampul duit raya punya envelope. Oh, okay. Okay.
So no need stamp lah, no need stamp lah.
No need stamp. So inti envelope tu nak kena, orang kata apa tu, berpada-pada lah.
Dan sesuai
sebab
lah.
Sebab dia bukan envelope antar international punya. Oh, where we can talk anything under the sun kan. Tapi ini bak dia sampul duit raya, jadi kena berhati-hati.
Harus, I think the main primary thing that we always use as a guiding as a guide for us is are we going to be proud of the kind of content that we bring out? So I think that is what really been the focus for Lipat One Corner. You know, kadang-kadang kalau kita nak buat benda pun, walaupun kita rasa benda tu macam sesuatu yang controversial and akan dapat banyak likes and akan viral, kita selalu fikir, will my parents be proud of me? You know, will I be able to go out and face people? So I think that's something that we always have to take note of lah, you know. Biar orang cakap, why you bother what people think? Yes. The truth of the matter is, I care about what people think. I care about what people think of my parents, of myself and everything. So that's that. Yeah.
Oh, ada tetamu eh? Siapa yang datang tu?
Siapa? Tak tahulah. Aku sekarang tengah circuit break. Jadi orang semua asyik datang je lah. Sekejap.
Tidak buka.
Sekejap eh? Tidak. Kau layan diorang.
Okay. Aku layan korang eh. Okay, baiklah. So, I think whatever yang Hafiz cakap tu ada betul juga. Sebab, like orang kata apa tu, memandangkan kita tak dapat buat video kan, tak dapat. Kalau nak buat video sekarang pun, kita nak kena apa, ada 1 meter social distance ke apa jadah lah. Macam mana nak buat video 1 meter social distance to all. Kan, jadi buat masa ni kita cuma buat podcast sajalah. Jadi semoga, I think ini memang kata it's high time for us to start this already.
Betul
kan? Makanan dah datang, you all.
Biasalah kan. Kalau macam apa tu?
Kalau suruh orang datang kat rumah buat kerja, mesti ada makanan.
Betul.
So adalah makanan datang. Nanti korang cekik lah eh.
Betul.
Korang tu sebenarnya Zuhairi dengan aku punya manager je lah kan.
Boleh bedah. Kucing kau nanti dia ambil makanan tu baik.
Taklah okey. Anyways, okey. So perhaps I think for those of them who just recently, I think mungkin because kita akan letak ni dekat Spotify kan. Jadi mungkin orang-orang Spotify tu belum pernah dengar ataupun menonton video-video kita. So like perhaps like we would like to give them a little bit of introduction. Macam mana like kita mula berkecimpung, buat kerja-kerja bodoh ni, jadi bapu eh, kena caci, kena herdik, kan, kena mengata.
Kita punya pekerjaan ni dah lah tak essential eh. Lepas tu dikeji, dihina eh.
Jijik. Habis orang nanti tulis hadis panjang-panjang, letak kat komen.
Dia tak tulis, dia copy paste je, babe. Macam aku tak tahu.
Kan? Habis pergi profile, dia dengar black metal.
Black metal. Pergi profile, gambar perempuan bogil. Kisahnya lah. Orang kata apa tu?
Selective. Virtue signaling lah.
Bak peribahasa kan? Kuman di depan mata, nampak. Gajah kat seberang tambak. Ya, betul tak aku punya peribahasa? Macam salah je, babe.
Gajah. Nampak. Gajah. No. Kuman di seberang tambak nampak.
Gajah depan mata. Buta.
Buta. Kita kena hempat untuk gajah. Anyways, please don't support going on elephant rights, okay? There's any of you over here who support animal rights, please.
Aku unfollow kau. Ada tak macam tu? Spotify ada ke unfollow-follow? Tak ada kan?
Tak ada. Please, animals are not meant for human recreational purposes ah.
Yes.
Let them be.
Tapi kalau nak betul-betul safe, alhamdulillah kita punya negara kita Singapore ni so far okay. Dia punya zoo dia tip top. In fact sekarang dong dah tak ada elephant rights. Dulu dong ada.
Yes.
Tapi sekarang dah tak ada.
No more elephant rights, no more elephant shows really.
Correct. Yeah. So kalau korang pergi luar negara itu penting kena tengok. Kalau sekiranya you nampak binatang-binatang ni macam buat-buat benda yang di luar daripada di luar tabii eh orang kata. Di luar tabii mereka, tolonglah jangan tengok. Don't support, okay? Because imagine kalau aku suruh kau kais-kais tai kat aku suka berak kat tempat public, lepas tu kau kais-kais macam kucing. Kau nak tak? Tak kan? So it's the same thing because the animals they are not used to or magic tricks
and stuff like that.
They're not used to do that because itu bukan natural thing for them.
Correct. So don't support circus, don't support animal attractions, okay? If you do want to go to the zoo, make sure you go to a zoo that has there's a term for it lah. Diorang where they
animal sanctuary.
A sanctuary of sorts. Yeah, yes. correct.
But please support the podcast by Lipat One Corner.
Gitu.
Yes, selit juga. Because we have to go to the different verticals, understand tak?
Yeah.
Yeah, there's different verticals. Okay.
Yeah, so basically like
who are we? You want to introduce?
No, wait, before that, I just wanna tell you guys also that I think this podcast will primarily be only the two of us. If we do feel like getting other guests, or we probably will, but also have to depend lah, because aku rasa synergy between kita dua ni pelik tau. Kita rasa kalau kita ada orang ketiga
atau orang keempat, kita orang tak tahu yang kita ni pelik lah kan, sebenarnya.
Mungkin akan ada rasa janggal kerana mungkin mereka tak dapat synergy dengan kita tu, macam tak ada lah gitu kan. Because we are very weird. Do you realize that we are very weird?
Aku baru dapat tahu hari. Okay. But manager kita bilang kita weird.
So don't worry. We won't sell controversy for likes. We won't sell controversy for listening our pleasure. And we won't be calling sex workers lah. Don't worry. Because we leave the sex workers alone lah. Someone now is phase 2, right? So
I don't think they are able to work yet.
It can, as long as don't group in groups of 5 lah.
Tapi 1 meter distance?
It can.
Boleh eh.
No, kalau dalam bilik.
Aku tak tahu lah, aku tak pernah kerja situ.
Kalau dalam bilik tak 1 meter kot. I think but when they are talking.
Asalkan Jakim tak tangkap sudah. Eh, Singapore kan, tak ada.
Singapore tak ada Jakim.
Oh, tak ada.
Ada. Tapi Singapore ada halal polis.
Ada ke?
Online halal polis.
Oh, halal polis. Yang macam copy paste semua lah. Hadis-hadis lah.
Yes. So don't worry, we won't be calling any of these people. I mean, if it serves a purpose, then yes, we would. You know, cause tak guna kalau kita membuat sesuatu benda tu tanpa without any purpose lah, basically. Kan macam setakat
kita
nak,
pun tak nak cakap lepas sangat, but maybe we have some guests.
Perhaps.
As of now, kita tak terfikir.
Kau nak tak menteri datang podcast?
Tak payahlah, babe. Kau, menteri nak datang rumah kau?
Itulah.
Tak payah sudah.
Mungkin kalau aku dah pindah lah, mungkin rumah aku senonoh sikit, mungkin menteri boleh datang lah.
Masuk bilik eh?
Bilik.
Ui.
Kan?
Tinggi tu.
We should call it like menteri dalam bilik.
Ui. Tembang dalam bilik. Tembang diranjang. Aduh.
Aksi apa tu? Aksi hangat eh?
Kita beraksi lah. Kita berbual kan?
Berbual.
Bualan hangat diranjang. Tiba. Melalut kan? Melalut kan?
Back to the future,
Okay, maybe like macam Hafiz cakap tadi, kita nak, for those of you yang baru dengar Spotify kita, baru kenal kita kan, sebab mungkin korang tak tengok YouTube and stuff kan. So, kita perkenalkan diri kita dululah. Mm-mm. Who are we, apa, a bit of our life story lah, from school till now lah.
So basically, Zuhairi and I have been friends since secondary school. I think we met each other when we were in secondary one. Because we were in the same Malay language class.
Kita di sekolah Bartley Secondary School.
Fakta non-verba.
Okay. Yeah.
Bartley School of Singapore. Up and coming to the fore. Let us hail our alma mater evermore.
Strong and steadfast we will be. For the strong community. With the spirit.
With the spirit of Bartley. Let's cry Fakta non-verba. And proclaim it near and far. Whether it be work or play, we'll go on from day to day and be well prepared to stand up to the fray. Alright. Fakta non-verba. Fakta non-verba tu, aku suka kita punya school punya motto, because fakta non-verba is Latin for deeds, not words. So it's like, jangan hanya berbual, buat. Betul tak?
Betul. Macam mana, Fiz?
Jangan hanya berbual, buat. Yeah. Tapi ironik ni sekarang kan,
kita berbual.
Tapi tak buat apa-apa. Aku tolong aku.
Tapi kita buat podcast lah.
Buat podcast kan. So I think it was one of the best quotes that I live by. You know, deeds not words, which is you are who you are not by the words that you say, but by the things and the deeds that you do. So I think it's something that we all can sort of emulate lah. So anyways, So aku jumpa si Bapuk ni dekat
Terhaka eh.
Aku jumpa dia dekat Bahasa Melayu lah, kelas Bahasa Melayu, when we were in secondary one. I think we were
time tu Cikgu Hassan.
Hassan. Sihat tak kalau Cikgu Hassan senang mendengar? Minta maaf Cikgu Hassan. Jadi Cikgu Hassan ya merupakan Cikgu Melayu kita. I think we were very we both enjoy Malay lesson, because number one, we were very good at the subject. So it wasn't a very stressful time for us, because we were able to buat karangan dengan baik, buat peperiksaan lisan dengan baik, kefahaman mendengar pun kita pun bagus, you know. Macam kertas kerja pun kita buat dengan senonoh. So we really enjoy ourselves, and I always look forward to going to Malay class, because I get to meet Zuhairi. And the only thing, no, because I think we were bullied.
Eh.
We were bully.
Kita macam kita kena bully sayang-sayang lah, bukan sayang bully lah. Macam bully jenis nangis mendadak, tak ada. Tak, kita memang suka macam
kita suka dibully.
Tak lah.
Kita suka dihina gitu.
Okay, to be honest, since kita ni buat podcast kan, kita macam nak katakan a bit more orang kata a bit truth lah. For me, I know this is not something new kat secondary school. Even in primary school also, saya selalu diherdik sebab saya ni a bit lembut. I don't know lah, maybe in terms of my talking ke, in terms of my walking ke, I don't know. Tapi what I know is that orang selalu panggil saya macam bapuk, kedi, you know, that kind of thing. So that is always something that I always not look I don't look forward bila saya pergi sekolah. Tapi bila masuk secondary school, also the same thing kan, lagi secondary school budak-budak remaja, then all these lelaki kan very aggressive, very ganas kan. So I'm a bit worried tau, sebab bila aku apply for Bartley, orang kata, eh, aku pergi Bartley tu gangster punya sekolah tau, gitu tau. Aku dah macam, alamak, aku dah lah macam gini, tapi gangster lagi, macam mana
dah lembut
ni? Dah lembut. So gangster lagi. So but then again, you know, we have to move on, we have to go through life. So I went. And then the first day yang Meli bahasa kan. The first day I was okay, chill. My classmate was fine. Of course lah, adalah some lelaki-lelaki dalam kelas tu kan. Macam tengok aku kan. Macam nak makan kan tengok aku.
Okay, lapar lah dia, lapar.
Then lepas tu I met Hafiz time Malay lesson. So bila I met Hafiz time Malay lesson, aku macam, ada lembut lah. Ada geng lah. Tu macam, okay, I'm not alone guys, I'm not alone. Tu lagu Rise of the Phoenix naik, Rise of the Phoenix, yeah. Sebab ada Hafiz. Then kebetulan pula dalam Malay kelas tu kita kena kacau.
Yes, sama-sama kita kena kacau.
Itu yang buat kita punya bond tu macam very strong.
But I think being lemah lembut for me and Zuhairi was really something that we have dealt with for most of our lives. That to the point aku rasa to the point I think lepas secondary school, kau sedar tak macam kau overcompensate, macam cara kau berbual, macam cara kau jalan, macam kau try to really macam be more like masculine. I find that I do that a lot, but I think now I'm very comfortable in my own skin lah. So I was very very upset when people keep on like macam cakap, kau lembut eh, lembut, asal kau berbual lembut eh, asal kau jalan lembut eh. And then I read somewhere lah. I think it was
this will be a good topic for our next podcast. Yeah. About lelaki yang orang kata apa tu, bersifat lemah lembut dan a bit feminine lah in a sense.
And then because I read this article cakap, apa salah kalau lelaki tu lemah lembut? Rasulullah tu kan orang yang paling lemah lembut dalam dunia. You know, daripada budi pekerti and all that. But of course it's not about like being feminine lah. It's really about macam the way he is as a person.
But I think for me is
that was my reference.
It's not just about the way we talk. I think it's also about how we
present ourselves,
jalan kita and stuff like that. Mungkin jalan kita ada macam sikit ada sikit apa orang kata lingguk eh. Macam lingguk ke apa, aku tak tahulah. Aku tak tahu apa yang orang nampak lah kan. Tapi
because for me it's normal. Pada aku normal kan.
When in primary school, okay, tapi I realise what you say is true. Semakin kita besar kan, we started to like macam headcare about all this. Because at the end of the day, it's like you can say whatever you want to say. Tapi this is me. I like, it's not like macam kita tak nak berubah. We tried what. But then kalau if you guys still spot something wrong with us, then it's not our problem. It's your problem, you know. Yeah. So like sekarang kau panggil kita punan bapuk, okay lah. Kita sendiri bagi kita bapuk.
So like you cannot hurt us because we are the first people to talk bad about ourselves, you know. So there's nothing that you can say that will affect us, you know. I really don't mind or don't care if people were to see us a certain way, because I know myself, you know, like when we do Bode Beda or Matema or Kiki and Shasha, it's not our lifestyle, it's not who we are, you know. Ia adalah satu
lakonan
dan karakter yang kita bawa, you know. And alhamdulillah, you know, people
and I'm sure there will be some of you who might be thinking, yelah lakonan pun tak boleh blah blah blah. Okay, fine, whatever, let's move on
back to the future. Jadi okay lah, so basically, so that's how we got to know each other lah. So kita punya synergy is very good because kita berdua ni amat serasi. We will laugh at the same thing, so we will crack the same jokes, and our sense of humor also the same thing.
So we always have an inside joke. So sekarang kalau kita keluar dengan kawan, or macam sometimes even the peminat himself, they will realize macam, asal korang ketawa sendiri. Itu korang faham lah, kita ada inside joke. So
So basically So basically macam mana kita mulakan Lepak One Corner, I've said this story many times, but I think it's worth to share lah. I was working with SGAG, so I think they wanted to have more Malay content, so they asked me. So I think at that point of time I was doing a Twitter account, like a funny Twitter account, and so was writing a blog lah. So orang cakap, eh, please do something for us lah, pasal our jokes are very Cina lah, so we want something that's very Malay centric. So I said, okay, fine. So aku masuk lah, aku buat lah content creation untuk SGAG. Then diorang ada YouTube page, so they said, eh, why don't you go and capitalize on this YouTube page, since we have the YouTube page, but we do not know what to put. So in fact, I was the first person, I was the first person to spearhead SGAG's YouTube channel. You know, if you really take a look at SGAG's YouTube channel, the first few videos of SGAG punya channel is my videos, which was Lepak One Corner season 1, you see. And then from then on, aku mulalah buat macam something about makcik, because I felt that it was something that I think at that point of time, you all ingat tak macam shit dads would say, shit mothers would say, you know.
So back like, then tengah popular lah,
so I wanted to capitalize on that. Then third episode, I was like, okay, aku tak boleh buat ni sorang-sorang, so aku rasa mendak and I need someone to bounce ideas from. So aku panggil lah Zuhairi. He was naturally the only person that I thought of. Please be reminded that he has been my friend since secondary school, and we laugh at the same thing, you know. And he's as talented, if not more talented than I am, you know. So I said, you know what, let's just do this. Let's just see how it goes. And alhamdulillah, from then on, you know, things worked well. So yeah lah, it all started from there. So then we decided to like move on our own, and then we do our own YouTube channel, and
terjadilah podcast ni lepas sekian lama, 5 tahun kita buat YouTube, yeah. Then kita masuk podcast. Lepas kita orang kata apa tu, people push us to keep doing podcast.
Yeah,
doing podcast.
You know, we've been receiving like suggestions from people to do podcast like since the beginning of time. And macam like bila podcast tu baru-baru nak naik, korang bila nak buat podcast sendiri. But we're like, we haven't found the time to do it, you know. But now that we have a lot of time, so we decide, you know, this is now the best time for us to do a podcast.
Right. And I think, but for now, kita punya plan, kita tak nak menyanyi banyak sangat. So we try to keep our podcast within 30 minutes gitulah.
Yeah, correct.
Sebab kita sendiri, ourselves, kau nak dengar orang menyanyi 1 jam tu memang tak larat lah.
Lagipun daripada sini kan, daripada Pasir Ris nak drive pergi Jurong, setengah jam aja. Setengah jam.
Ya ke? Bukan 1 jam ke?
Tak. Setengah jam. Kalau kau drive expressway,
Kalau MRT, bus lah 1 jam. 1 jam lah. Sebab dia berhenti-henti kan.
So korang boleh lah senang sedih. Korang dengar kena podcast setengah jam yang naik MRT tu, kau dengar lagu.
Tapi tahu mana tahu ada orang Malaysia dengar ni.
Apa khabar orang Malaysia? Aku rindu tau pergi Malaysia.
Apa khabar orang Melaka? How are you?
Apa khabar orang Perak? Apa khabar orang Negeri Sembilan?
Orang Kelantan apa khabar?
Orang Nogori. Nogori Sembilan.
Nogori Sembilan. Orang apa yang yang macam Terengganu.
Terengganu. Okeylah, jadi itulah episod pertama kita. I think we have to wrap up, okay, because I think we want to do the best for you guys.
So, but what can we call our followers?
Is there
a specific name to call our followers?
Bloods Dami. Bloods orang Dami. Jadi kita panggil apa? Urine.
No, I didn't, right?
You call yourself urine lah. Urine, snap. Or salivas.
Kalau blood dah ambil, kita ambil ni lah.
Perangai dukun Leo salivas.
The pods.
Okay, nama
the pondans. No. Tak kalah kita, kalau kau dah call menjadi pondan pula. No.
Okay, tak apa. Korang komen and korang kasih kita DM on what is the best name for you guys to call yourselves, alright?
The lepak.
The lepas, probably lah.
Boleh, the podies, the outcast. I don't know. I mean, you guys are more creative than us. So, let us know apa korang nak dipanggil lah.
Correct.
Kan, sebab Bloods dah ambil. Ahli neraka pun orang dah ambil. Ahli syurga nak? Ahli jannah.
Ahli jannah. Kita, Ahli jannah. We work towards attaining paradise lah.
Whatever Muslims, it is, if you have any ideas, let us know.
Okay. Till we see you guys again. Nama saya Hafiz Rahman.
Saya Zahid Idris dan saya dah lapar sekarang ni.
Kita akan makan dulu. We'll see you on the next episode of Lepak One Corner, the podcast.
Bye.